That's a bright ass shirt you got on there, son. And welcome everyone to lovely Clitheroe. I love Clitheroe, such a lovely place. And it's a lovely sunny day, as it always seems to be in spring at the moment in the UK, which will probably mean it's going to be a bit of a crappy summer. That's how the patterns seem to be following on. We get lovely Aprils where it's supposed to rain, then it'll chuck it down then through May, June, July, and we might get a nice August. But anyway, as I climb up towards Waddy Fell, I had, or I'd like to tell you about, a really good day I had yesterday. I went and attended the Ron Haslam Race School at Donington Park in the UK, and I did their premier course, which is a sort of half day session with an instructor, like two guys to one instructor, riding CBR 600 RRs around Donington. It was really good. I really enjoyed myself, and it was my first ever time on a track, and first ever time riding a Supersport 600 as well. So I'd like just to do a bit of a review of the Ron Haslam Racing School's premier course, and I'll include a little bit of my thoughts and feelings on the bike as well. Well, I think I did a vlog, in fact I know I did. I did a vlog before Christmas where I explained that, as I have now bought this bike which is quite sporty and handles well, and I've never had a bike like this before. Out of the many, many bikes I have had, I've never had one that could handle as well as this. So I've wanted to get a bit of experience and a bit of training, because you're never too old. You're never too old to learn. You're never too old to pick up new skills. And I'm certainly old enough that I've picked up lots and lots of bad habits in my riding career, all 27 years of it. So I thought a day in a school environment would do me good in many ways. Because what I want to be able to do, or what I wanted to do, which was the aim of the day, was to have a little bit more confidence cranking bikes over into corners, you know, getting the knee out, and subsequently getting the knee down. It's been a long time since I've been able to get the knee down, and I feel like I've kind of lost the bottle for it. And in the UK, as we drive on the left-hand side of the road, it might be the same for all countries that drive on the left, there's not many, but that when you are driving on the left, all the sharp turns you seem to make, where you know you can actually have a chance to lean off a bit and get the bike cranked over, they all tend to be right-handers, because we have roundabouts, filter lanes, things like this, where you tend to make that sharper, quicker turn to the right. There's not that many opportunities for a nice left-handed long sort of drawn out bend. So I thought, well, if I do it on the track, I can pick up some good skills and practice to be able to sort of be confident in taking the bike over in left and right hand bends. So anyway, I was booked in for an afternoon session starting at 3:10, and I got there a little bit early, and it involved a lot of waiting around until my sort of group was called. So I stood and watched at the side of the track for a bit. And yeah, it was really good to see the bikes going past around the Melbourne hairpin at Donington Park, and just kind of seeing what they were doing. You know, I could see the red CBR 600 RRs going around, and I could see people riding the Fireblade 1000s on the elite course on a one-to-one, one instructor, one student, going much quicker. So Benjamin, I took my own gear, but the price of the course for the premier course was £295 UK. This included the, you know, the use of a very new and bog standard sort of set up for the bike. There was no, you know, no loud pipes on it, no braided hoses, and the tyres that were on it were pretty much standard sports touring road tyres, the Batlax T30 Evo. Anyway, so you got the use of one of those. The only thing they had done with the bike was they had taken off all the lights, the original fairings and bodywork, and put on a set of fiberglass track day sort of bike bodywork. And there was lots of them, and they were all quite new bikes, you could tell. They said they're new for this year, and you know, they're all really good nick bikes. So you got one of them, if you needed it, full leathers, helmet, boots and gloves. I just took my own gear and I used a set of their boots because mine aren't that good actually. They gap a bit at the front of the car, at front of the shin. So if you've got nothing at all, you can just, they'll provide you with everything, and that's fully inclusive in your £295. If you turn up with your own gear, it's still £295. But anyway, so when your group's called, you're given a coloured armband, and there are sort of two groups that run parallel. One will be out on the track, the other will be debriefing, and then you swap bikes and go out yourself. Now, a lot of people seem to go with the friends and members of the family or such. So you'd have two people who'd obviously come together with one instructor. Now, I had gone on my own. So I got paired with this other guy who had gone on his own, and it's the only sort of bit of a bummer of it was this guy was like 65 years old, and when the instructor asked us, you know, what are we hoping to get out of the day, what skills do we want to practice on, well, I said, well, I've just bought a sports bike and I want to learn how to corner properly and feel confident in cranking the bike over in the bends and getting the knee out. He says, right, good, can do that. And he says to the other fellow, and what do you want to do? He says, well, I just want to take it nice and steady me. And my heart fell because without even asking him, I didn't even need to be asked. I knew that, well, it's going to go at the pace of the slowest guy, obviously. So I thought, oh, crap. But anyway, so we went out on the first session on the 600s. And we did a couple of sighting laps just to get used to riding on a track and riding the 600s. And what they had done around the track at Donington is they had put out cones. You know, they put a red cone out for where you would start braking, a yellow cone out where you'd do your turn in, and a green cone on the apex, which is what you sort of aim at after you've turned in. It took a little bit getting used to, I must admit, getting the positioning right, because it's totally different than on the road, but it feels so much safer. I mean, you're on a pristine motor racing track, Donington Park, which I know it's the only track I've ever ridden on, but you can tell why it's a world quality track. It is superb. The surface is immaculate, and the corners are just, you can tell it's just been really well thought out, and it just flows really well, you know. It's really started to get the hang of it, and I'll give the guy who I was paired up with his due. He got on it a bit as well. He started to speed up, so it was going really well. So we ended the first session, then you have a bit of a debrief, and he says, right, well, I've seen you riding now, which is, I don't know how he could have. He just looked at us in the rearview mirrors of his bike. Because the instructors on the premier course were riding Honda CBF 1000s, like touring bikes, but you'd never think it because they were hauling ass on them, they really were. I couldn't have come anywhere near him on the CBR 600 just because he had so much skill, this guy. Anyway, so he gave us some pointers on, you know, how to position yourself on the bike for maximum sort of bike control authority, pointed us out some where we've been going a bit wrong on the lines, things like that. Second session started and we went out, consolidated a bit. Now, the one thing that kind of annoyed me a little bit was the 600s have no rear view mirrors on them, so the instructor who's in front of you, like three bike lengths in front of you, he can see what's coming behind on the in his rear view mirrors. Now, what he would do is he would hold his left arm out, sort of like this, and that meant follow him out the race line because there's someone faster coming through. And he seemed to do it quite a lot, because you had on the track at the same time the elite courses who are on fire blades, and of course they're going much quicker. So you'd just be getting yourself positioned to do, you know, you just come through Schwantz and you were just looking to do the double apex at, I can't remember what it's bloody called now, the bend at the top, the double apex before you go into the back straight. And you just, all right, I've got to get the knee down here, I'm feeling, then next thing, oh no, he pulls you off the race line, and it's like, oh, for crying out loud. And you're getting between sort of 8-9 laps per session, and you only have 3 sessions, mind, and it's a bit, oh, it kind of annoys you a bit. And then, anyway, so, but you're learning some really good skills, and it's fun, don't get me wrong, it's as frustrating as it was being pulled off the race line occasionally, it really is good fun. At the end of the day, how can it not be? You're spanking a CBR 600RR Supersport, which isn't yours, and you've got full license and permission to spank this bike as hard as you can around one of the best motorbike tracks on the World Superbike calendar. You know, this is like proper bucket list stuff, this. Anyway, so we have a bit of another bigger debrief, and then it's time to go out on the third session. Went out on the third session, and what he did this time was, you know, one, either me or this other guy would be behind him, and then he'd sort of make a signal and we'd swap around, so we'd both get a chance at leading. And when it was my turn to lead, we always just seemed to get pulled off the race line because of faster groups, and it got a little bit frustrating. And then someone come off in another group, so the red flagged, which means everyone was into the pit lane while the major elephant was all right and picked the rider up and picked the bike up, and then everyone was out again. And then so we did another couple of laps, so just getting back into it again, and then he signalled for us to swap over, so the old boy went in front of me. Now, I'll give him his due, he was doing his best, and he was giving it a fair old crack of the whip, and you could tell from the debrief that, you know, he was keen on it and he was up for it. So, you know, but he just wasn't as keen and up for it as me, and I'm like screaming at him, going, come on, get going! You know, like, as I was really, really wanting to put a bit more speed on so I could, you know, translate a little bit of that speed into angle of lean at the corners and hopefully get me knees down. But anyway, it didn't happen because we got towards the end. There was another red flag and we come off, and it must have been like only one lap to go, but then they didn't send us out again after that. But anyway, so slightly frustrating, but nonetheless very, very well organised, superb equipment and bikes, and instructors who are obviously, you know, very, very, very capable track riders, because none of them have any knee sliders left, you know, and the guy that took us round was about 10 years older than me, and it's like, well, if he can do it, I can do it. But he could do it and I couldn't do it. But anyway, so it was excellent day. And slight frustrations aside, and that's only my character, that's just me, you know, getting all impatient. But what's there not to enjoy about blatting a lovely 600cc Supersport bike around a sorted racetrack? Nothing at all, it was brilliant. And I was so taken with it, and I had such a good time, that straight off and out of the bat, I just went up and booked the elite course for next month. And I'll be the one that they're slowing everyone down for, hopefully, maybe. So yeah, so the Ron Haslam Race School Premier Course gets a big old V4 thumbs up. I would recommend it to anyone who wants to improve the riding, even just road riding, or if you've, like me, plan to do some track days on your new sporty bike, then it is a £295 well spent. Because like, if you've never been on a track like me, and I haven't been on a track before until yesterday, it just, you just know what's coming. And you, and it's very, very, very safe. At no time at all did I feel unsafe. There was one little moment where I nearly locked it up on the Melbourne hairpin and nearly like front low sided it, but I didn't, so it doesn't count. Now there was, like I said, there was quite a few people on track of mixed abilities, but at the end of the day, everyone's there to learn. And you're not there to race, you're there to learn. It's not like, you know, you're not going out there to overtake people. So yeah, I recommend it. It's a great, great value for money. £300 or, you know, small change out of 300 quid might sound a lot, but I don't begrudge paying it whatsoever. It was a super value, and yeah, go and do it, because I'm going to do the elite course next month in May. I'm hoping that the weather stays, or the weather will be nice for that day like it was yesterday. I imagine it's a totally different kettle of fish when it's shit weather, but yeah, really, really, really good. And Ron Haslam was there, old Rocket himself. And he was taking people on pillion passenger rides around Donington, which, nah, I would never do that, because that is just, that'd be crazy scary. Like most people who always ride at the front, the pillion scares the crap out of me, it really does. And if you've got someone like Rocket Ron, XGP bloody bike racer, taking you around, yeah, I suppose I would do it, just for the sheer been there and done it-ness of it all. But, ooh, I might have to change my leathers after. Anyway, but also the CBR 600, superb little bike. Man, I mean, it's got loads less power than this machine, but all the power it has is really up in the sort of 8,000, 9,000 RPM range. But when you get it up there, holy crap, it shifts, and it handles so, so well. You know, I was cranking it over as far as I could, and there must have been times where my knee was like an inch off the floor. I couldn't have been far off. And the bike just felt so, so stable, you know. And I've kind of always like overlooked the 600s, thinking, well, you know, I'm a biggish bloke, might as well get a litre bike. But no, I can see the attraction, I really can. Certainly for track riding, they're brilliant, brilliant fun. So yeah, VeeFour says, go and do the Ron Haslam Premier course. Dead, dead good. And you can completely forget how to ride like I just have. Anyway, I'll report back on the elite course once I've done that, but I'll probably speak to you all before then, and I'm just going to go out for a nice little ride into the wilds of Lancashire on this very pleasant, pleasant sunny day. So, I will, as always, catch you later.